100 to Somali with us. Got some bitch from Fallas with us. She gon' fuck your squad with us. I'ma fuck her bras with us. Bitch from Pakistan with us. Ferraris in them lambs with us. About to fuck this club up with us.
Metro Boomin' want some more, nigga.
I turn the Ritz into a pole house. It's like eviction number 4 now. Go ahead and that shit on the floor now. Girl, go ahead and show me how you go down. And I feel my whole body peeking.
Hey guys, what's going on? So I got another video for you guys tonight. And you know, like I said, I don't aim to disappoint when I'm trying to tell you guys I'm gonna upload. Hey, but things happen. And yeah. If you messaged me today, check your email because I might have hit you up. So, you know, and for all those that I couldn't get to, I apologize. All right, so now what are we talking about here today? Or tonight, rather. All right. Okay, so what are we talking about? So we're talking about radioactive energy and its connection to your superhero mangas, animes, movies, in general, your superheroes, and the connection that it has to our carbon-dated folk on the planet Tiamat here, where we are, where we stay at. And yeah, this is Sirius Inner Temple, our spiritual network. So yeah, let's get started. All right, so there's various things that I want to say. Number one. Okay, I don't know how many times I gotta say this, but I apologize if I'm being redundant, okay? Black people, Hispanics, Africans, your Brazilian people that are obviously of carbon, and anybody else that has what they were referred to as Negroid blood. Look, see, here's the thing. See, y'all were tricked, see. Y'all was tricked to think that you were actually a part of the human race. You're not. In order to be human, you have to be like these people that have animal genetic and all kind of other stuff going on in the genetic that has to do with, like, animals, ogre genetic, believe it or not, how crazy that sounds, I know. Sounds insane, doesn't it? They have animal genetic, and they have a very small piece of our genetic within them to give them a humanoid shape, the shape that they have today, the humans. Your whites, your Asians, your East Indians, your Arabs, your Dravidians, your East Indians, your Mexicans, your El Salvadorians, your Ecuadorians, those are humans. If radiation hits these people, it will kill them. They, most of them are also sulfuric people from the very beginning. You know, what happens to sulfur when it's ignited? It combusts. And this is why you hear things like, what you refer to as your spontaneous combustion. Yes, when white folks stay in the heat for too long, if the heat is at a certain level, they will actually spontaneously combust and explode in flames. Yes, because they don't belong on this planet. Think about it. If you belong on the planet, why is the atmosphere killing you? Exactly. It's because you don't belong here. We've talked about this on many different videos, guys. So this is just catch up for the people that don't know. Your people of carbon, like your Hispanics that have, you know, what you refer to as black blood, like your Haitian blood and stuff like that. If you're Haitian, if you're like, I don't know, like Dominican, Puerto Rican, if you got like some type of, like, you're African American, if you're African Brazilian, you know, if you're from Africa, if you have this, or what you refer to as your black blood inside you, because that's not black, it's what it really is Anunnaki or Anunnaki blood. We are of a different species. We're not human. And the human race knows this because that's why they have something called the United Nations. And this is where they get up and they talk all about us and how to keep us down and out. Okay? They're already very much aware that we're not like them. This is very much true. You can see it in your sports and everything else that we do. We always outshine them. It's evident. This is why they need to make all kind of efforts to slow us down and halt us down and stuff like this. This is why most sports is rigged, because they don't want us constantly winning all the time. We are different than these people. They are called humans. We are called Anunnaki or Anunnaki. And we are not the same as them. And this is why they're talking about Comet Atlas coming and whatever the hell else is coming. This is the end time. 2020 is the end time. And now, as you can clearly see on the screen here, you see your Supermans, your the Incredible Hulk, your Dr. Manhattan, your Spider-Man, and even Radioactive Man that came out of The Simpsons. That cartoon, you know, those yellow skin looking people, The Simpsons or whatnot. Notice that your greatest superheroes all were hit by some type of radioactive energy. When we talk about carbon dated folk, like your peoples of carbon. And for those that don't understand, I'm going to try to explain it here. But if you don't understand, try to look at my other videos, because I'm not going to keep explaining the same thing over and over and over again. I'm not going to do it. Okay? Because some of these questions that some of the people are asking are becoming redundant. I've already answered it. So if you can't understand what I'm saying in the video, which I don't know, I don't understand how you can't understand what I'm saying. If you can't understand it, go back in the other videos and do a little time lapse and go back in time and try to understand what I'm saying. Trust me, it'll take a little bit of time, but it's worth it, because then you'll understand what's truly being said. What is carbon? It's called dark energy or dark matter. It's a form of dark matter in a physical state. Dark matter naturally is supposed to be in a gas-like state. The darkness that's outside of our planet, outside the atmosphere in outer space, that stuff is called dark energy or dark matter. It exists everywhere in the boundless universe. It is the limitless energy that gives all things existence. So darkness is literally the zero point of all things. Darkness is the zero point of all things. Darkness is the only thing that really matters at the end of the day. Now you have a people that were composed of this dark energy. And the sunlight, which is also a part of dark matter. See, light comes from darkness, not the other way around. Darkness doesn't come from light. Darkness creates light. You need to have darkness first before you can have a light. Don't you need to have darkness first before you can turn a light on? Exactly. You don't just have a light out of nowhere and then you turn on darkness. That doesn't make any sense. Exactly. It doesn't make any sense. So in order to have a light turned on, you need some type of shading or darkness, do you not? Exactly. We have a people that's composed of darkness, dark energy, and they like to call them your so-called black people today. All forms of black people all over the earth, not just African Americans. We got plenty of them all over the planet. Okay? All right, all peoples, all forms of carbon. Now, listen very carefully. Condensed sunlight, even scientists know this. Condensed sunlight creates something called carbon. Yes, in a physical state. Carbon is a physical form or manifestation of dark matter energy that's out there in our cosmos. Because our skin has this carbon coating, carbon is coming from radioactive energy, your ultraviolet radiation coming from the sun, but it's been condensed and it turns into carbon. So we need to feed our bodies radioactive foods like your vegetables and your fruits and stuff like that. These fruits and vegetables have radioactive energy in them, light particle energy in it. That's why when we eat the food, our organ energy field or our auras become stronger and we become healthier inside, because we're eating radioactive food. Do you understand? This is very important because you so-called black people don't even understand what the hell you are. I want you guys to watch, Watchmen. Watch the Man of Steel. Watch the Incredible Hulk again. Watch Spider-Man. Hell, even go watch the Simpsons episode where they showed you Radioactive Man. And you will see that your most powerful superheroes all were hit by a certain form of radiation or ultraviolet radiation or some type of radioactive energy. Every single one of them. Okay, for example, your Spider-Man was bitten by a radioactive spider. They did all kind of tests on and stuff like this, and then the spider was radioactive. And it mutated him. And it changed him. Your Dr. Manhattan. He was hit by ultraviolet radiation. He was hit by a machine that was carrying all kind of radiation in it, and it caused him to change permanently. Same thing happened to the Hulk. You saw what happened to the Hulk with that machine. What happened to him? He got hit by some kind of radioactive energy, and it changed him, made him powerful. He rose in power, and nothing could stop him. Same thing with Dr. Manhattan. Who the hell you know that could be Spider-Man? Now, your Superman. Look at your Superman. He gets his power from a yellow sun. Your Superman gets his power from the yellow sun. There was even a point in the series where he almost died, but because he was in outer space, the sun healed him and he became even more powerful than what he was before. Did you know if Superman goes inside the sun, he can become he even has a godlike form. What is it, Superman 1 million or something like that? Superman Prime, I guess it is, or whatever the case is. He becomes so powerful that nothing can stop him. He even shoots fire and radiation out of his eyes. Explain that. His eyes even become like an X-ray where he can see through your body. And he got all these other kind of abilities added along with that. All of these characters that are some of the most powerful superheroes. I mean, look at Dr. Manhattan. He could practically do anything with that radioactive energy that he got. So much so that in the movie Watchmen, people were actually complaining and getting radiation sickness, and all these humans were getting radiation sickness from being around him. That's what they were saying, that they were getting radiation sickness from being around him because he's a radioactive being. What they didn't know is that he can actually control his own. What they didn't know about him is that he can actually control his radiation levels. He can push it down to where y'all don't get sick, or he could boost that shit up so high that y'all will literally start boiling right in front of him. Yeah, boiling right in front of him, or getting sick and dying, bleeding out and having all kind of seizures on the ground and dying. Yeah, because that's what the radiation does to humans. But notice something with these superheroes. All of these superheroes are Caucasian. Notice that. Why they do that? It's because they know the truth about you carbon-dated folk, and they know that you guys are really them. They know that you guys are really them because when they came here off of those spaceships that we talked about, they saw y'all as these beings, and they saw what y'all could do. They saw how y'all were. They know that the radiation is the key to giving y'all power back permanently. But once y'all change over, y'all never be the same again. And they know that. They know that. And then radiation needs to be at a really high burst. Because our bodies, our carbonated bodies, feed off of radiation. And when we talk about 5G and what 5G can do for us, 5G is, listen, 5G is a damn good thing. Listen, 5G is a damn good thing. We're not human. And that's the problem with black people. All you so-called black people all over the planet. All you peoples of carbon, you Hispanic people, y'all, you Hispanics, man. Yo, you Hispanics, man. A lot of y'all got an issue. Y'all think y'all human. Alright? Alright, you're not an orc like these Mexicans and and these people, those are fucking orcs, man. They're not like you. They're a different species. They're human. Radioactive energy will kill these white folks and these Mexicans and all these other people. It'll kill them. It's not gonna kill you, though. In fact, it's actually gonna start making you stronger. Now, can chemotherapy kill black people? If you're not on a vegan diet, chemotherapy can possibly kill you. Why? Because all that stress and strain on the body, and then your body's out of balance. Yeah, you get sick like that or die. Yeah, absolutely. Now, if the radioactive energy, the radioactive energy is hitting you, and you stay in that radioactive energy, is it healthy for a black person to be in a radioactive environment? Absolutely. I say the more radioactive energy, the better. Yes, you heard what I said. The problem with so-called black people is that you guys think y'all human. I got people sending me videos online of them having psychic abilities and doing all kind of stuff. And they're like, oh man, I can't wait to meet you in this up-and-coming battle. And I'm like, you damn right, brother. Because I already know what's going on. I know what the hell I am. I know what's going on. We are radioactive beings. We are radioactive people. We're not human. We're Anunnaki or Anunnaki. You guys have an issue on the planet where you think that you're human and you can just be with these people. You may be able to have children with these people. That's only because they have 2% of our genetic added into the creation process when they were created by Enki or Prometheus. He added a drop of his blood in there, which is one of our brothers. That's the only reason why we can mix in with them and have children with them. Other than that, we are not the same, and we're not the same species. Radioactive energy cannot affect white people like this. How do we know this? Look at what happens when they stand in the sunlight. Radioactive energy, ultraviolet radiation. Look at what happens. First degree burns, second degree burns, third degree burns, even a disease called melanoma, which is a melanin-based disease. So if black people don't catch melanoma, we clearly don't have melanin then. Duh. So if we don't have melanin, what the hell do we have? Because we're not catching a melanin-based disease. We be in the sun all fucking day. You see those Africans over there, they don't have a fucking problem being in the sun at all. We have carbon or outer dimensional dark matter in a physical state called carbon. Do you understand? And we are going to become very capable of doing these kinds of feats very soon. This is why I stress meditation. This is why I stress a lot of meditation every single day. Every single damn day, if possible. Go on a vegan diet. Get that radioactive food inside of you. You understand? No meats. Okay? The meat hinders your evolutionary process as a species. Okay? No meats, no soda pop, none of this stuff, man. Avoid all this stuff at all costs if possible. Okay? All right? The 5G is going to literally start making us become, believe it or not, it's going to activate the angelic psychic abilities that are within us. And we will once again become the almighty immortal beings that we used to be. These bodies that we have will literally dissipate and we will gain new bodies. Yes, this is what's getting ready to happen. The government, they're going to dish out 5G because they have to implement what it says on the Georgia Guidestones. They have to implement their plan, erasing the mass majority of the human race, on the human population on the planet. You know that's what it says. But the thing is that the radiation is only going to give us our strength and powers back, and they know that. They're afraid of having too many people on the planet. Because if there's too many people on the surface, they're in danger. Because they're underground. So they need to eliminate the threat that's on top of the surface. Because they're trying to go underground. Here's the thing, though. We're not human. So when that 5G goes on, and a lot of them already know what's going to happen. A lot of them don't know. A lot of them do know. And they're scared. They're scared because they know when Comet Atlas, or whatever it is that's coming out there, hits here, it's going to change us regardless. So see, they're going to give us 5G because they know that even if they don't do 5G, whatever's coming is going to hit us in the same manner as 5G, and it's going to force us to change over. And the 5G, they're going to be having this stuff hitting on the planet in major bursts. I'm talking about major bursts. You've never felt anything like this before. This kind of radiation, you've never felt this before. Believe me. Y'all about to see. Y'all about to change over. I'm telling you that right now. And see, the thing is, secretly, the 5G, it's an apology. It's an apology in a way. Yes, they want to throw off nature's frequency and fuck shit up even more. Yes, they do. These are not good people. But at the same time, you know why they're giving y'all the stimulus checks? And now they want to do $2,000 next following month or whatever the case is. And now they want to give up 5G or whatever. They scared and they sorry and they hoping that y'all going to be, forgiving enough to forgive them or whatever the fucking case is. That's not going to happen. We're not going to allow that shit. All right? Absolutely not. Y'all got to get what's coming to y'all. Okay? And the radioactive people on the planet are going to get what is owed. We are radioactive beings. Don't let anybody tell you any different. Know in your hearts that you're not human. Because that is the case. That is the scenario that is being dealt with right now. That is what's going on. Okay? If you look at all of your greatest superheroes, they all have a radioactive connection. They all have some type of connection with nuclear energy. They all have that kind of connection. All of them. They even got a guy called Nuclear Man or something like that. These orcs, these humans, white folks, and all these other ones, they know that radioactive energy can do this to us. That's why they played in these movies and in these roles. And they already knew that this was actually a reality, that this is actually a real situation. Okay? There is reasons why these people fear us. There is a reason why. Because we are not like them. And they know that at some point, something's going to have to give. And we're going to go right back to where we started. And this is why they fear the pole shift that we just talked about in the last video. Because the pole shift is a reversal of all the damage that they've done. And because we fell during the first pole shift on the planet, the reversal is going to put everything back into perspective in the way that it's supposed to be. Putting us back on top where we're supposed to be. On a permanent. All right? They done. The Illuminati, all these people, they done. When this shit hits, we will never be the same again. And all you ones that got a broken leg, you sick in the hospital, you're on your last legs, you want the hospital, you're dying from whatever the fuck it is, sickness, you got your arm amputated because a shark bit it off. I don't know, man. Whatever kind of freaking problem you got with your body, when this radiation hits, believe me, you're going to have a brand new body. Believe me, you're going to be coming out here looking like Radioactive Man. Look at him. Yeah. Yeah. You're going to have all... Your body's going to be completely different. You're going to be thinking different. All of that DNA that they call junk DNA in school, that's not no damn junk DNA. That's your God gene DNA. It's going to all be activated. All those strands of DNA are going to be activated. You're going to finally remember who the hell you are. You're going to remember your real name. You're going to go so far back in time, you're going to remember who the hell you are. And man, I'm telling you, the world will never be the same again. I'm telling you, all these buildings are coming down. Everything's coming down. All these school systems, these schools ain't opening back up. I'm telling you, they trying to give you this money because they sorry and all this other stuff, and you know they want mercy and all that. There is not gonna be no damn mercy. There is not gonna be any goddamn mercy. So stop asking for it. All right, what's gotta happen has got to happen. All right, those ships that people have been seeing up there. Now people are saying that they're seeing the second sun in the UK, in Britain. They're saying that they're seeing the second sun over there, and they're saying they're seeing the second sun in what you would call that place? Forgot the name of the place, man. Whatever, they're seeing it all over the place now. People are seeing the second sun all over the place. It's almost about wrap-up time for all this. Saudi Arabia, yeah, that's the place. In Saudi Arabia, they're seeing the second sun. In the UK, they're seeing the second sun. Very soon, we're going to see it up in here very soon. The end is literally around the corner, like I said. So this is a little explanation on why you so-called black people, okay, you're different from everybody else. Okay? Your hair is a sun disc, for goodness sake. Okay? Alright, that's, you understand? That's not hair on your head, that's ether. You wasn't made with no animal genetic, okay? Alright? Same thing goes for you mixed ones, you know, you so-called biracial children. You have this radioactive particles within your body as well. You may not be like the ones that are fully the species, but you guys are half. You do carry a solar plexus within. You do carry a soul. You do come from what we come from. So you guys will be changing over as well. You won't change over all the way because of the fact that you're half and half. But when we done doing what we doing, we're going to remove that orc genetic from you. And you'll be a full carbon dated person. But you gotta prove yourself first. Show what side you on. This is what's coming, man. We're gonna have all kind of meteors hitting. The streets are gonna be going crazy. People are gonna be screaming out there. The floor is gonna be breaking up, man. I'm telling you, this is you're gonna hear the cars honking and dogs barking, screaming. You're gonna have people going crazy. The police, you're gonna be hearing all kind of like screaming going on. It's gonna be utter absolute chaos. And the order is going to come in to fix all the chaos. But the order has to be the creator of the chaos first. You know, the order is going to come in, but first there needs to be an extreme form of chaos. Because the order is responsible for the chaos. There needs to be chaos in order to establish true order, because the world's out of order and things don't make no damn sense out here. Okay? So, you know, like, comment, subscribe. Is your boy Sirius in the temple? This is all I really had to say. Just try to understand what I'm saying to you. You know, just try to understand. This is not no joke. We're not making this stuff up over here. All right. This is reality. All right. All your movies have to do with some type of truth for the most part. All right. And if you can't grasp what I'm saying, hey, you know, that's on you. You're not ready for this kind of information. That's all it shows me. You know, they desperately trying to tell y'all out here, even in the movie industry, you know, they trying to tell y'all Dragon Ball Z with those people fighting the way that they fight. I mean, all these, what is it with these people and this fascination with having powers? What is this fascination? Is that they saw y'all like this. Their envy has to come from somewhere. They are not like you. And they see what y'all capable of already in a physical state. If y'all become energetic, it's curtains for them, and they know it. And y'all gonna become on an energetic level that's gonna go beyond anything they can comprehend. That radiation, that radioactive energy. The sun on our planet is evil to them. Why? Because it's killing them. Okay? Alright, they made a fucking huge mistake when they came to this planet and started destroying shit after the Pleiadians started destroying the towers. They made a goddamn big freaking mistake when they came here. And now they're gonna pay for it dearly. Did you know some of our people can actually take that form of the Hulk? Did you know some of our people can actually take that form? Don't take these powers lightly, because let me tell you something. Not all of you have the same abilities. Everyone is different. Not all of you are the same. You will even notice amongst each other, some of you can do more than others. Okay, not everybody is the same. Some can do other things that others can't, and some can do some other things that the other one can't. Be very aware of this, because y'all gonna notice these things. Not all of you are on the same level either. Alright? Hey, man, you know, it's your boy, Sirius in the Temple, and I'm out, man. Like, comment, and subscribe. It's your boy. Tell me what you guys think. Hit me up. Let me know what's up. Anthony, take care of yourself. Jared, it's always a pleasure. Hey, you guys take care of yourselves, alright? Alright? Zakil, take care of yourself, man. Hey, man, you know, Olivia, take care. And, yeah, you know, I'm just here just trying to tell y'all what's going on. Just pay attention to what's going on, especially on social media, on the internet, on YouTube. Please pay attention to what's going on. Visit all these places that y'all need to visit. And don't stop either, because this shit's right around the corner, guys. All right, it's your boy, Sirius in the Temple. I'm out. And yeah, that's really all I have to say on this one. Alright, that's all I gotta say. Alright, you guys take care of yourselves, alright? Alright, serious out.